I'm Dr. Raglan, Dean of Zombie Hunter University. This is the fourth in a series of lectures on the scientific minimalist approach to Dead Frontier weapons. Rifles are looting weapons that can be used to dispatch individual zombies. After melee and chainsaws, rifles are the easiest weapons to optimize in terms of allocating stats and proficiency points. Rifles are quiet weapons, but they are not silent. This means that they do not provoke aggro, but they will attract the attention of zombies within hearing range. Rifles typically deliver more damage per hit than equivalent weapons in other categories. Rifles are effective at a distance, which means they are safe to use even for students with low endurance and weak armor. Rifles use rifle ammunition, obviously, which is usually more expensive than pistol ammunition. Boxes of rifle ammunition hold 600 rounds. Rifles rely on stat points in critical hit and reloading. Adding points in accuracy is optional. Rifles do not require strength. Most rifles are high critical chance, which means they require a total of 112 stat points in critical in order to optimize their odds of delivering critical hits. A few high-end rifles are very high critical chance, which requires only 80 points for optimization. In either case, an optimized rifle will deliver critical hits 80% of the time. There are two types of rifles, bolt action and carbines. Bolt action rifles have very slow firing speed, which is one shot per second. They have higher damage per hit than comparable carbine rifles, and they have very high accuracy, with a few exceptions. Carbine rifles have slow firing speed, which is 1.5 shots per second. They have higher damage per second than comparable bolt-action rifles, and they have high accuracy. Generally speaking, it is good to think of bolt-action rifles as long-range weapons, good for sniping slow-moving targets from a distance. Carbines are better at close quarters, as when dealing with swarms. High-accuracy rifles can achieve reliable aim with 60 stat points in accuracy and perfect aim with 80 points. Very high-accuracy rifles require fewer points, 40 for reliable aim, 60 for perfect aim. This means that students can use very high-accuracy rifles without putting any base points into accuracy. Points from equipping master-crafted weapons will be enough to achieve reliable aim. This is a tremendous advantage for freshmen and sophomores who cannot yet afford points in accuracy. Is it advisable to add stat points into accuracy in order to achieve reliable aim or perfect aim with high-accuracy rifles? In practical terms, this is a luxury, not a necessity. As students progress into the far eastern regions of Fairview City, they will find themselves surrounded by crowds of fast-moving zombies. In this kind of close-quarters combat, points in accuracy will not be necessary to hit targets that are only a few feet away. Practice and careful aim yield better results. Adding points in accuracy can be beneficial for students who want to achieve perfect aim for sniping at targets from a distance. This is useful mostly for boss hunting. For students who want to improve accuracy, we recommend capping stat points at 60. This will yield perfect aim with very high accuracy rifles and reliable aim with high accuracy rifles. This is a good compromise for students who may find themselves switching back and forth between the two types of rifles. Rifles and pistols serve the same purpose, quiet looting. There are significant differences between rifles and pistols, but also considerable overlap. For this reason, rifles and pistols should never be combined in the same build. To some extent, the choice between rifles and pistols is a matter of preference. We recommend rifles for beginning students for these reasons. Rifles have lower stat requirements than pistols, making it easier to optimize them during lower division semesters of this course. Low-level rifles are more powerful than low-level pistols, another advantage for first-semester students. As with melee and chainsaws, our recommendations for rifles are based on threats that students face in each of the different colored zones illustrated on the map of Fairview. However, in the case of rifles, the local threat levels must be factored in with other considerations, especially as they relate to reloading speed. A rifle that can one-hit kill a zombie is useless if the zombie kills you while your weapon is reloading. Rifles provide a good example of the weapon's proficiency paradox, which we have mentioned in previous lectures. Because of the differences in accuracy, rate of fire, ammo capacity, and damage per hit versus damage per second, upgrading to a weapon with greater proficiency is not a guaranteed improvement in performance. Students must weigh the pros and cons of each new rifle, considering what purpose it will serve in their build. Even the weakest available rifles, the Beta RX4 and the Mini 41, do enough damage to one crit kill all zombies in the blue zones. Unlike most bolt-action rifles, the Beta and the Mini offer only high accuracy. They are good enough to get by, but the first rifle that we truly recommend is the SL-8. This 20 proficiency, high-accuracy bolt-action rifle is slightly more powerful than its predecessors, but its real advantage is ammo capacity. The rifle's magazine holds 30 rounds, enough to fire continuously for half a minute without reloading. This benefit is almost incalculable for students with few or no points in reloading. In fact, it is so significant that it makes the SL-8 worth holding onto instead of upgrading to more powerful rifles with smaller clip sizes. The SL-8 needs 2 hits to kill green zone threats, but it can kill burned and irradiated female zombies with 1 critical hit and 1 non-critical hit. It can do the same to sirens in the yellow zones. In fact, the SL-8 can be useful in orange zones, and, when handled with extreme care, it can be adequate in more dangerous territory east of Fort Pastor, though we do not necessarily recommend this. The next available rifle, the 30 proficiency bolt-action M24, is the first one capable of 1 crit killing a siren. Unfortunately, this rifle is severely debilitated by its ammo capacity, a mere 5 rounds. Unless a student has maximum reloading, this weapon should be avoided. The 40 proficiency bolt-action M1 Garand is the first rifle with very high accuracy. It delivers as much damage per critical hit as a 100 proficiency battle axe, enough to kill burned and irradiated zombies with a single shot. Its ammo capacity is still low, 8 rounds, but students may find it useful for looting, less so for crowd control, because of its very slow firing speed. The next 4 rifles are essentially the same as the M1, but with larger ammo capacity. The 50 proficiency Chesterfield, the M21, and the Glacial Warfare all hold 10 rounds per clip. The 60 proficiency MSG9 holds 20 rounds, making it the first rifle that is clearly a superior upgrade for students with slow reloading speed. Though the very slow firing speed is not ideal for fending off swarms, the MSG9 remains effective in orange zones inhabited by spiders and tendrils. All that is required is maximum agility and good dodging skills. If necessary, students could even carry this rifle into the red and black zones and use it effectively. While we are on the subject of the M1 versus the MSG9, we should stop to make an important point about reloading. The difference in magazine size is significant only for students with very poor reloading. With fast reloading, the two rifles are virtually indistinguishable. Therefore, students who have maxed their reloading stat can save money by using the lower proficiency M1 Garand. This is true for other weapons, such as the Hawk Op 96 and the M8-2A2, which will be discussed in a moment. The 75 proficiency SIC-550 is the first available carbine rifle with a firing rate of 1.5 shots per second instead of only 1 per second. With only high accuracy, the SIC is essentially a Mini 41 that fires slightly faster, without enough damage per hit to kill a siren with a single shot. Though it has the same magazine capacity as the MSG-9, those 20 rounds disappear faster because of the increased firing rate. We recommend avoiding this weapon. The Hawk Op 96 and the M8-2A2 are essentially the same rifles, the latter simply has larger ammo capacity. Both of these bolt-action rifles feature very slow firing speed, very high accuracy, and an impressive amount of damage per shot, enough to kill blood dogs with a single critical hit. The 80 proficiency Hawk Op 96 holds only 7 rounds, making it a poor choice for students without maximum reloading. The 90 proficiency M8-2A2 holds 15 rounds to make it a solid upgrade from the MSG-9. Students who use these rifles will find them very effective at killing red zone threats. Just remember, you're going to need to move fast to outrun any swarms. Students with 90 proficiency points for rifles have another option besides the M8-2A2. The Dragon SVD is a carbine with high accuracy and a firing speed of 1.5 rounds per second. Its damage per hit is less than that of the M8-2A2, but it is enough to fell a siren with a single critical hit. The rate of fire delivers more damage per second, which makes the rifle more effective for crowd control. The faster firing speed also provides more knockback. Upon reaching 90 proficiency and having these two options available, this is a perfect opportunity for students to experiment with the two different types of rifles and then decide which they prefer going forward. The 100 proficiency VSS Vinteres is essentially a slightly more powerful Dragon SVD. It is a carbine with enough damage per shot to kill irradiated and burn zombies with a single critical hit. This is an excellent crowd control weapon, and it does well against boss zombies too. juniors and seniors can even use it against giant spiders and wraiths if their dodging skills are up to the challenge. This rifle is virtually unbeatable in orange zones, also useful traveling further east into red zones if students have the appropriate skills for the more dangerous territory. We want to stop briefly to mention the Rebellion rifle. It cannot be looted in the city of Fairview. It must be purchased in the credit shop of Dead Frontier. It is slightly more powerful than the Vinterez, but the key feature of the Rebellion is that it requires only 40 proficiency points for rifles, which makes it a good choice for a third weapon. After passing level 50, students receive only 2 proficiency points for attaining each new level, which means that raising proficiency to 120 for their third weapon can take months. In the meantime, the Rebellion will serve students in good stead during the long time it takes them to graduate to epic level rifles. In the red, black, and white zone, students will encounter flesh hounds, long arms, and rumblers, along with black and irradiated species of the latter two. Greater firepower is definitely useful under these circumstances. The 110 proficiency bolt-action 577 Rex is the first rifle with enough damage per shot to kill a long-arm zombie with a single critical hit. This is very helpful when looting in red zones. The fewer shots fired, the less chances of attracting unwanted attention. The Rex can also kill spiders with only 3 hits, only 2 of which need be critical. Though the Rex's very slow firing speed is problematic when dealing with swarms, careful dodging will compensate, and the extra damage per second is handy when dealing with boss zombies. The key feature of the Rex, however, is its very high critical chance. The Rex needs only 80 stat points in critical to be optimized. The Rex will work perfectly well in a build with 112 points in critical, but those extra points do no good for this rifle. Students who purchase the Rex may consider a stat reset to a hybrid build, moving points from critical into strength to enable the use of shotguns or heavy machine guns. All subsequent rifles discussed in this lecture are very high critical chance, which makes them good for stat resets to hybrid builds, although of course they will work in critical builds. The 120 proficiency iron sight offers more damage per shot than any other rifle, except for unobtainable limited edition items and unique items. It is a significant improvement over the Rex because of its ability to terminate rumblers with a single critical hit. It can also defeat spiders with only 2 hits. In red zones, this rifle is virtually undefeatable as long as students stick to open spaces and stay one step ahead of crowds. The only commonly available rifle more powerful than the iron sight is the Warg carbine, which is unique among rifles in that it has a firing speed of 2 shots per second. Unfortunately, the Warg is so expensive that it is out of reach for undergraduate students. Instead, we recommend the limited edition Marksman G8. Normally, we eschew pricey limited edition weapons, but in this case, the Marksman is not as exorbitant as the Warg. The 120 proficiency carbine offers less damage per hit than the iron sight, but more damage per second because of its faster rate of fire. In confined situations, such as looting indoors, the benefits are obvious and worth the extra expense. With their reliable aim and impressive damage per hit, rifles are an excellent and safe way to hunt bosses. Titans and Mothers are easy prey to anyone using an M1 Garand or better. Faster bosses are trickier because rifles do not provide enough knockback to slow down giant spiders and wraiths. This is complicated by the fact that these bosses tend to be accompanied by heavy aggro. However, a VSS Vinterez can take down a giant spider or a wraith in a reasonable amount of time if students are able to isolate it from the swarms and dodge well enough to avoid being hit. For bigger bosses, flaming giant spiders, flaming wraiths, and black titans, rifles are unlikely to prevail unless students are using speed enhancement drugs. If so, high-end rifles such as the Rex and the Iron Sight will kill the target sooner. Students who wish to make a career of boss hunting should consider raising their accuracy to perfect aim in order to make sure that every bullet counts. Rifles are an excellent choice for freshman students seeking a long-range weapon good for looting and low-level crowd control. Rifles are easier to optimize than pistols, and they provide more firepower at lower proficiency levels. Mid-level rifles will serve students well during their undergraduate semesters. Upper-level rifles, with their lower critical hit requirements, offer an option for a stat reset to a more powerful hybrid build for graduate students.